I have a Russell Hobbs toaster that has come in for repair. The complaint is that when you start it, it burns the bread and doesn't automatically turn off. Now, let me show you what I'm going to do with it and how I fixed it. I will provide all the details. First, I have already removed the screws from here, and 4 screws are left, so I'll remove them now and then show you the next step. So I've opened it up, and the first thing I'll do is remove the lever so that it can be opened easily. Here you can see that there's a tray for catching the extra crumbs, so I'll take that out as well. Now I'll go ahead and open it fully. Now first of all, look at the connections here. Since there is a PCB inside, I will first remove the connector to make it easier to open. I've removed the connector. Next you can see the earthing wire here, so I'll press it down. There's also a connector attached here, so I'll remove that as well. Now as you can see, everything is completely separated. Inside here there's a PCB, so I'll check that. Besides that, you can also see there's a PCB here, and inside it, there's a magnetic relay and other components. I'll open it up now and show you. Here, you can see the knob attached. Now, I'll open both PCBs. There are screws on top, so I'll remove them, and the PCBs will come out. As you can see, I've opened the PCB. Now I'll test it to see what the issue is and why it's not working. I'll explain everything as I go along. Now look here, this is the potentiometer, and it's not functioning properly, so I'll check it. Besides that, there's a control IC, as well as some resistors and capacitors. I'll test all of these, but first, I'll start by checking the resistors to see what values they are giving. Now I'll check it. It's showing a value of 0.47 kiloohms, which means it's working perfectly fine. Apart from that, I'll also check the potentiometer by removing it and testing it separately. As you can see, I've removed the resistor. It's a 470 kiloohms resistor, which is fine, but the potentiometer is causing the issue. Now let me check the potentiometer. As you can see, it's not showing any value, and even when I turn the knob, there's still no reading. This indicates that it has short-circuited and is faulty. I'll go ahead and replace it. Here you can see, I've removed the potentiometer. Now I'll check it. Normally, you should see resistance values on the sides, but in this case, there's no resistance value showing at all. Now I'm checking the wiper, but it's also not giving any reading, which means there's no value being shown anywhere. This confirms that the potentiometer is burnt out and needs to be replaced. Once I replace it, the toaster will work perfectly again. And friends, as you can see, the potentiometer I checked isn't available in the same model. So I'll be using this one instead, and I'll show you how to install it. You can see that this potentiometer was originally installed, but since we couldn't find the exact same one, I'll be using this one. Since there was no clip for it, I made a clip myself. This is my own invention. As you can see, now I'll show you how to install it. So, our potentiometer has been installed. I installed it very well, and it took quite a bit of effort and time. Please like this video so I can get more motivation. As you can see, I've set the knob's position perfectly. When I attach this knob, it will fit perfectly. Now I'll check its resistance for you. When I turn the knob, you'll see how it changes its resistance. Now, I'll show you the test of the potentiometer. As you can see, when I turn the knob, the value starts changing. Notice how the value is gradually increasing in kiloohms. Now it has reached 250.1 kiloohms, meaning the resistance is at half of the total 470 kiloohms that are installed. This shows that the potentiometer is working properly and adjusting the resistance as expected. So, the toaster is now completely ready. Let me show you the test. Initially, the issue was that when we pushed the lever, it kept running continuously, causing the bread to burn. But now that we've replaced the potentiometer, I'll turn it on and show you. As you can see, the light has turned on and the toaster has its own timing. Right now, it's set to level 1, which takes about 1 to 1.5 minutes. This is the time it takes to function properly. Let me show you the light turning off. Inside, the heaters have turned on and are doing their job, and the light is on. After a short while, the heaters will turn off, and the lever will automatically pop up. And now, as you can see, the lever has popped up, and the toasting has stopped. Click on the left or right thumbnail to watch our next videos, and subscribe. Thank you.